Hello friends, I am Jitendra Pal Singh and you are learning about WordPress in English language. In last video you have learned about pages section, and in this video I will tell you how to create a menu and submenu under that using WordPress. But before that I want to cover this comment section. So clicking on comments. So after clicking on comments you will see a page where you will see all the comments submitted by your viewers on your website. So in short, if a user of your website will comment, and then you will see that comment through this comment section. User will always comment on your post, but it depends on you that you want to publish that comment or you want to held for review. So you will have these options in every comment. You can approve or unapprove a comment from this link. So from here you can reply to the user's comment. Like this person commented that please add more tutorials on this topic. So you can reply, okay, I will, and then click on reply button. So if you want to delete a particular comment, then you can click on this trash link. And if you will see a spam message on your comments, then you can report to that comment from this link. So you can perform whatever action you want to perform on your comment. For example, if a user will comment on your post, then that comment will by default go to the pending section. So if you will approve that comment, then that comment will be shifted to approve section. And if you will report that comment that it is a spam, then you will see that message under spam section. And if you will delete a comment, then you will see that comment in trash section. So that's it for the comment section. Now let's learn how to create menus in WordPress. So for that, under appearance section, click on menu. After that, click on this link, create a new menu. So here you can enter a menu name. It's just a reference, so you can set any name. I'm setting it to Jatinder underscore menu. And then click on create menu. So after that, you will get this message on your screen. Add menu items from the column on the left. It means that you can add menu items from left sides. So we have four options on the left hand side. First is pages, post, custom links, and categories. So let's add some pages here in the menu. In the last video tutorial, I have created some pages, home, about us, contact us. So I am selecting all of these. You can select according to your choice. So now I am adding it to the menu. For that, click on add to menu. So here all these three pages are settled in the menu. So from here you will only see an option of most recent pages. So to view all the pages of your website, you can click here view all. And you can also search for a page from search option. So for now I am going to save this menu by clicking on save menu button. And after that you will get this message, Jitendra underscore menu, my menu name has been updated. So from here I am checking this primary menu option to make this menu a primary menu for this website. And if you will tick on this option, then all newly created pages will be automatically added in this menu. Then click here to save this menu. Now let's check this menu on our website. Click on refresh and here you can see. According to my current theme, my menu location is here. So these are my pages, home, about us, and contact us. So now I have a menu of these pages on my website. But now you might be thinking that this is not the perfect location of a menu. Mostly menu appears on the top of the page or at the bottom of the page. But I want to tell you that it depends on the developer of the theme that where he has set the menu location. So according to this theme, menu location is on the left hand side. That's why it is appearing here. So if you want to understand the menu concept properly, then let me change this simple theme to a new one. So for that, go to the appearance section. And the first option is theme. So click here. So I'm going to activate this theme, 2014. See, this theme has been activated. And click on refresh here. So here you can see the change. So according to this theme, on the left hand side I am having recent post here, and here I am having recent comments. So our menu is here, our homepage, contact us, and about us. Now I want to sort these pages in the menu. I want homepage first, then about us, and then contact us. So for that, go to the admin panel. So you can simply use drag and drop option to sort out your menu. So I want homepage first, then contact us, and then about us. And then click on save menu and refresh here to see the changes. So here you can see homepage first, then contact us, and then about us. Exactly like this as I want. And we don't have any restriction that we can only add pages into the menu. We can also add post in the menu. Here you can see we are having most recent post here. And by clicking on view all option, you can see all the posts. So you can select the post according to your choice and then click on add menu. After that, click on save menu and refresh here to see the changes. So here you can see a link of that post into the menu. So it was just an example. I don't want this post into the menu, so I'm going to remove that. Now let's see how to remove it. So click on the menu item that you want to remove and click on this remove link. So after that we have custom link option. Means if we want to create a link instead of pages, post and categories, then we can create that custom link from this option. Let's create a custom link with the title my friends. So for now I don't want to give it any link. So just type hash and click on add to menu. Save menu and click on refresh to see the changes. Here you can see a link with text my friends. After that we have categories option. So I am selecting HTML, CSS, PHP, all these categories to the menu. Save menu, refresh here to see the changes. So here you can see a link of HTML category. I am clicking here. So I will see all the posts related to HTML category. This is the first post and this is the second one. Now let's check CSS category, where we have only a single post, and same in the case of PHP, single post. Now let's learn how to create submenus under this menu. So as we know, HTML, CSS and PHP are under web development category. So I'm changing this my friend link to courses. I'm in web development course. So from here I'm changing it to courses. And now I want to set HTML, CSS and PHP under this courses link. So for that you only need to drag menu items to the right hand side like this. Now here you can see HTML is a sub item of courses now. So I'm creating CSS and PHP as sub item. And then click on save menu to update and refresh here to see the changes. So here you can see our submenu is ready. Under courses we have HTML, CSS and PHP link. Now let's create one more page. There is a reason behind that. And here I am giving it a title services, publish, refresh, and here you can see a newly created page automatically added to the menu. This is because I have already explained you that if you will tick on this option under menu, auto add pages, then WordPress will automatically add new pages to the primary menu. So this was the practical example to show you that. So here you can see how easy it is to create a menu with a submenu under that with the help of WordPress. So in the next video I will tell you about theme customization. So stay tuned and put like on this video on YouTube and also subscribe to my channel for more videos. I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching this video. Take care.